So, currently, we pretty much have a solid base. There are just a few loose ends, and there are indeed still a couple of things that we should confine, but we haven't yet confined. But there are some issues with regards to that, and then mainly dependencies, like for example, it's kind of hard to go through them. I should have probably marked them in some kind of way. But there's this Nautilus control server, OS Connect server, and Nautilus Sentoo, I think. That's beside the loose ends, because there's also a lot of stuff that another data convert, for example, is also still pretty much empty. But yes, I just don't know how to basically reproduce what they do, to be honest. So it's kind of hard to your Nautilus Sentoo is also empty yet. We just declared a type, but nothing else. So yeah, it's kind of to do these domains is kind of hard, because yeah, I just don't know how to trigger them, except that Nautilus Sentoo, oh, and Nautilus Outer Run is also a tough one for me, since, well, this is a virtual machine, and I don't actually have anything to outer runs. So yeah, these are just kind of things that I'm just going to ignore for now. So with that in mind, you could basically consider this to be a solid base with loose ends. That means that these domains aren't tested yet. They are tested very limited. They do what I until now needed them to do, and anything else probably will not be allowed, and so you'll get plenty AVC denials yet. So let's just log in and let's see where we stand. So that we are currently in enforcing mode, and we have don't added rules loaded, so it should be all silent. It's 10:15 currently. No matches, so let's log in. So I guess at this point we can basically start doing some stuff that is basically not directly needed, but would be nice to have. And like one of those things is probably gedit. It's probably nice to have a text editor working, so that we can actually open text files in Nautilus. But and then there's other plen nice stuff. Of course, you have that Totem suite, and your audio suite is probably also nice. Well, plenty stuff, at least. We could, for example, just well, we can't actually deconnect. Try to connect to the server, because basically updates are available. Because basically we would need keys, and I removed the keys, so can help be run directly from the shell. No, so that's something we that's another loose end. So that's something we can actually do. Oops. No, and then grab. Yep. And then just add that. So GNOME shell runs yelp. G shell runs yelp. So there's plenty loose ends, of course. Maybe like that. And here we have an issue. Oh yeah, right. So at that point, run shell is not declared. G shell. So we need to basically declare it here because there's some ordering going on. So we can remove this one here because we need it more on top. So that's a gotcha with regard to attributes. You really need to think about ordering, I guess, but with regard to requiring types, that's not important. So that's a gotcha, or actually, yeah, and it is important probably when you declare types as well. So just remember that sometimes ordering is relevant. So we just assign the type attribute to num shell. We should now be able to run it. Although there might be some ABC denials. So here's that Yelp program, and it runs. So let's see ABC denials. This is something we can ignore because that was from when it was denied. Currently we allowed it, like it says, this ABC is allowed in the current policy. We allowed that by just assigning the runCLP attribute to num shell. Let's see if there's some debugs. Doesn't look like it, although we have a lot of other errors with regard to network manager also, but those are pretty much unrelated, I guess. So yeah, that's one of those things. So let's just start with the edit. That's probably user bin gedit, I guess. So let's do an RPM query file user gedit query file, not query list. And then RPM query list gedit less that. So that's actually two. And then you have here a file browser plugin. Quick open plugin. Oh, these are the plugins. But let's just start with, and let's have a look at those. Maybe it's a symlink, although I doubt it. Yeah, it's actually a symlink. Alright, so it's just user bin gedit. So let's just go ahead and start something. FC. And go all the way below, user bin gedit. Let's just do space here. And then just gedit exactly. It's always nice to have a file editor working. Let's see now. Oh, we go all the way below. get something. I'd like something that's run by Shell. But of course that's very high up, but you always see that. G-term is actually ran by G-shell, so we can use this. And then just paste that in and edit that. Yeah, at this point we're pretty much have a base. There's always loose ends and it's never solid. But this, well, it is actually solid base. But it's never comprehensive. Let me just put it like that. But it is actually solid. Pretty solid. There are some things that you need to actually be aware of. Like stuff like, there are some programs, anything that can run generic binaries, generic shells, that should basically, you should keep an eye on those during the course of developing the policy, because yeah, that basically means that they can run any program, and you might not want it to run a program that's currently labeled with a generic binary type. You might want to decide to just label the binary with a private type instead and set up a domain transition. But at this point it doesn't really matter, because you'll see it by yourself if it runs a generic binary, if an existing domain runs a generic binary and all of a sudden it needs a shitload of new permissions, then you know that you might want to look into actually using a named file, using a file type transition, domain transition. Save this, and if it doesn't run anything extra, then it might not even be worth to transition. Unless it's of course creating some file that you want to have a private type. But yeah, those are just things you need to basically keep in mind. We need to basically restore the context of gedit and basically start all over again. I hope gedit hopefully isn't such a complicated application. Although it might just be. But it does the obvious stuff. Restore on the user bin gedit. So I basically also already allowed gedit to run the Yelp program. Set and force 0, and then as in module db to expose hidden. But that's just to keep something to keep in mind. I already allowed it to run Yelp, so that's an assumption that I did. So we did that, so let's just try this again. Run gedit. Raya. This is permissive mode, by the way, in case you didn't know. And now just basically have a look and work, go to work. Oh, less it, of course. But now we don't actually at this point have to less it, fortunately. So here we have the basics of the edit, and that's all pretty obvious stuff. The stuff that you'd expect. So we can borrow a lot of stuff from others. Actually, so which domain, like for example, events. Really could borrow plenty of stuff from events. Let's just take the obvious stuff first. You know, I know it's tempting to just go ahead and get it all. Yeah, we actually know that it's going to need all, but yeah, let's just verify. That's a shitty thing. I know it's going to be eventually use stuff because yeah, I just think like what it should be able to do, and then I relate that reference that to the rules. And then I basically can imagine that it would need it, but yeah, imagining is not always bulletproof. So, and although it isn't always that important to, if you allow something that you shouldn't allow, you still have it confined pretty solid, although it may be just a bit excessive. It's still contained, but yeah, it's just not something I encourage, because where's the limit? I mean, so for example, I know that in gedit you can open the file selection box, and then it will need to list the whole user home directory, or at least give a representation of the whole user home directory. So that's why I basically just add this already, user home type already, but that's just assumptions already. Like for example, metadata. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that it needs to read that, but it's not in the list yet. So in that regard, I'm going to skip that for now. Just, oops, Christ. Anyways, I don't need that anyways. This is just basically I'll just copy that again. the list is getting longer and longer. So yeah, for example, what do we have here? Fonts. So we can remove the fonts already. We have tconf and data home key, which is tconf data home key search. And here it's actually reading it. So in that regard, we need to actually read and open. So it's that different. Then we have tconf functionality, which we also added here. Tconf temp functionality. We have home root T. And then we have password file T. We already had that from above. Then we have X server stuff. Then we have user home dir, read, search, get attributes. And that's also something we have already. User home T, dir, get attribute. We also have that already. User temp T, that's for deconf temp T, and this is X server. We also have it. So this is basically what we have left. Now we can basically get that deconf config home stuff already. So events, and then get it from there. So this is basically it. I could have basically done that manually myself. And yeah, this stuff is all obvious, that either stuff also that's going to happen, because there is some, of course, some awareness for internationalization, keyboard layout and stuff like that. Although it's just not showing up yet, but that doesn't mean that it's not going to be there, and that XDG home is actually already there. So remove that. Oops, keep using the wrong stuff. And here we have also GTK functionality, and you know it, it's going to be using GTK. So let's just add that and also add the GTK functionality. That's basically that bookmark stuff. You know, when you basically open that file browser, you know that you can bookmark stuff probably, and or at least to some extent. Maybe it just needs to read it. Maybe it just needs to read bookmarks, like for example open. Now you can you can't actually add bookmarks here. Seems. Oh well. I'm not sure why that is though. Yeah, you can actually add bookmarks. See? So that functionality just needs to be there. So yeah, that's something that we're going to take care of. We're going to borrow that from events. If events uses that, but I'm pretty sure that does. And that recently used is also just needed. It's just, yeah, stuff that makes sense. It's the file dialog that has that recently used section. So that means that it's going to display the recently used files. That means that we're going to have to add files to that recently used stuff. Okay, and then GTK bookmark stuff, back, events. Okay, where are you? Here it is. So yeah. with regard to config, yeah, that's still not allowed, that add and write name, so we can basically add that in. And here you have that as well. See, I added here the read for data home T for this one, but it's not actually needed here, but rather, yeah. Because it's actually related to recently used, not so much related to just traversing the local share. So this can be removed. When we have eyes out, we can leave that in. Then we have it actually connecting to the user session bus, and this is all stuff that can be left in there. And then basically you can be pretty sure that it's DBS chatting already, less far log messages. See, at this point it's already chatting. So till and 100, well actually 100. So yeah, we can already do these. And then go all the way down and fix that DBS stuff. This is single. And then just go through those. The basics. So yeah, plenty of this stuff is just, you just know it, and also with regard to managing generic user home content, that's something that we can already add in, because you know it's going to need to be able to open generic files and to actually write generic files. And we also know that it's that Nautilus runs this shit, because if you open a text file, then it probably automatically opens with the edit. So we could basically shell runs this, but also a lot of assumptions to be made there. Take care of that as well already. After a while you really start to think like a computer, or yeah, like a computer system. You really know, okay, this is going to have to be able to do this, and to be able to do this you need to do that, and all that stuff. So, that's now also taken care of. So let's have a look at how that works for opening generic files. Basically, we need to at least add a type transition here. Type transition. Gedit needs to be able to create files in the user home directory. User home directories, and it only applies to files because Gedit doesn't write anything else than files. User home t. So, and then basically, what it needs to do is it needs to be able to create content there. So how does that work? Well, I think file roller might have similar properties, or actually events as well. Oh yeah, we have that old printing stuff. You bet your ass that you can print. So we can basically add this. This allows it basically to manage generic content. Just above the file type transition. You can add this, but yeah, this can be removed because we already have that. And this can be, for now, don't audit it because we don't want to, don't audit stuff that we. What you get here is it can add entries and remove entries from generic contenders and the home user home there. But here it's creating a dir, and yeah, that actually much not sure. Not sure if you're actually able to create dirs. Doesn't really make sense, does it? Although it's not like a big deal either. But yeah, since it's a file manager, let's just keep it this way. Or file manager, a text file editor. So I don't actually see how it would need to create theirs. So you have this print dialog. So let's just open that. You have print preview. Well, then you know what's up. But this is that basically that full-fledged stuff, so we actually need to take care of that. So yeah, it runs events. And it needs that whole events. That whole print stuff. So we have this block here coming to print, and you can bet your ass that it's gonna need that. stuff is coming to printing, and the random device, yeah, we don't have that yet. Self TCP, we don't have that yet, and then we have queuing game and sync connecting. So yeah, we just need to go on and get that done. I'll just make a note that it's coming to print for later. And might actually also need to be able to run Nautilus. Let's have a look at that. If it says open a file in the file browser or something like that, then you know. Or open file in location, then you know. Although it might not show that here. Not now. Nah, that's probably not yet applicable. So, save and exit this. Make it. As a module. I mean, if I install vanilla Red Hat, let's just leave it. Okay, let's have a look. Because we did some stuff in the meanwhile. That's that. So it's trying to get attribute. Oh, it's reading bash. Might be a good idea to allow that. And now it's also doing stuff in config home tree, and although that might just have to do with TTK bookmarks or stuff like that, it might also be that it's actually. So we have a lot of stuff yet to do. First, let's just take care of. Yeah, I can basically get most of that stuff from others. Uh, That was Radio Humpty. Trying to do some of this basic stuff. That was Radio Humpty, and we don't want it to get out to this. It's actually there that's also loud, so most of it is seems loud. Just need to take out the config stuff here. Let's just grab that. Should have just looked for years of create, and that's actually the GTK. So yeah, so far it doesn't actually seem to create anything else, but at some point it's going to want to do that, obviously. For example, if I go to the preferences, I change some preference, close that, then I'll look at what we have at 50. Nothing. So that's maybe, let's have a look at the home there. Let's all see home, my login user, and like stuff like config. Has it actually created a gedit thing? Neither has it here. And neither has it here. So it's just not creating any gedit stuff yet. Okay, so let's just move along to the next phase. Except that let's just less for log messages once again. This all taken care of. Yeah. Okay. Make app. NG module. So it actually doesn't create anything out of the ordinary yet, so that means that we can basically just move on. Restore con rvf home my login user. See, it's all the simple stuff. So yeah, let's just create a file. Hello world, and then save it here, save it, okay. First things first, though. See if we missed out some stuff. Yeah. Config home. Is it now creating a gedit? Yeah, enchant. So enchant. So that's a dictionary. Let's just take care of that. Actually, let's just, yeah, no, let's just do first things first. So config enchant. So let's go to a config enchant. Enchant, call it enchant. Might be used by others. So yeah, enchant config home t. Enchant config home t file type and user home type. User home type, and then we can already do the type transition. And that's basically my login user jetted t config home t dir. And then it's enchant config t. Then it's for enchant. And then basically we can add in that stuff. It's just doing, yeah, it's actually creating a dir and a file. Now, since it also already creates other stuff in config, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. See here, we don't actually need to do much except this stuff here. Right, add name, remove name, search, get attribute. Yeah, that makes sense. And then these files do that stuff. Because basically it creates a dir, and inside that dir, it creates a file. And although it might not need to be able to remove that dir, I'm just allowing that. So that should take care of that. I can basically restore call on this path. I just restore call in its whole directory. There we go. So yeah, on to the next thing. So actually I was able to save that file. Am I able to print preview without problems? Oh, this is a different print preview. It has its own print preview. But it also has the other print preview. You see this print preview. Oh no, it's not. Oh yeah, yeah, this is actually, now am I crazy or what? Let's have a look. Seems like it might actually be different print preview. PS aux z grep 10 12. Yeah, it's not actually the same kind of print preview. It has its own internal print preview. Yet, it doesn't really matter, because it actually needs to. It's a tough issue. No, it's running damp. It's weird. I'm just going to allow it anyways. So we have some I'm just going to try to fix it properly. So we have a type jetted tempty type attribute spell type. You have the temp file. Then you have user temp type. And then what it does is it doesn't actually create a file. It doesn't actually create a dir, sorry. Get it empty. This is it. And then we have a type transition. And it's not a dir, it's a file. Just creates a file. Alright, so that's taken care of, at least the basics. You'll actually want to also get attribute and search. Yeah. Now I'm going to remove that even stuff. That runs even stuff, because I need to confirm that, but it's pretty obvious though, at least it seems obvious. So you got this stuff here. But yeah, it doesn't show events in the list here. Now it's done. Let's just show a print preview. This works. Close the preview. Then, oh yeah, of course it works. Because it's in permissive mode. Print preview. Close preview. Print into file, and I'll just take a login user, so just put it here. Actually, yeah, it actually doesn't run it. Doesn't actually say, it actually says I don't need that. I do my own print preview. No, that's fine. That's fine with me. Does it actually run Yelp though? Next thing you know, that actually does run Yelp. We have actually all these. I assume so, and if not, we'll see later. Yes, var log messages. I have any AVC denials with regard to debust, and we do actually have gedit chat into GVFS metadata, and I'm pretty sure that we need to be able to read metadata as well, and we haven't added that yet, but I'm pretty sure. So let's do this chat. Add that in. I'm pretty sure that's the case. It's going to have to be able to read metadata. I might add this. It's no big deal, anyways. So now I'm going to basically log off, remove my home door, and just try this in a forcing mode, see where it gets me. Oh, actually, I should try this one first. So yeah, let's open this in the edit, see where that gets me. Might be some Nautilus chatting involved. Oh, actually, we have some other stuff here. This is don't audit it, so we can actually ignore that. Well, with regard to this config entity, grab config. Might be mislabeled stuff or might not. Oh no, we actually have here gedit. So let's take care of that as well. Go where the other stuff is that enchants. I'll place this in here for now. I'll just copy this over and use that. Might be a shortcut. Get it. Basically have the same stuff, although we have a rename. This basically is the same, but then the edit. Get attributes. Read, create, open. Might need more later, but alright. So type transition, I can basically get that from, oh no, it's not the same one. We get it from here. Jared. Jared. Let's take care of that. Now we have an unknown type. See if you have some debugs chatting with regard to Nautilus. Doesn't look like any. At least not. Here we have some stuff. But it's metadata, we already did that. So it doesn't look like it. So yeah, let's see where this gets me. I'll just clear these two. Move the trash. Move the trash. Close out, log out. And then clear the directory and stuff like that. And then go in enforcing mode and just reproduce in enforcing mode. We're out, so it's kill all you, my login user, and then it's clear my login user shell, and then it's let's all z home my login user. Looks clean, and then we're going to lsalt temp rmrf temp. And then set enforce one. So we're enforcing, supposedly. So let's just start by just first opening it up. It opens at least, so that's the start. So we still have the don't audits removed, so we're still going to get a lot of stuff that's not applicable. That's all looking clean for now, so let's just open a browser. Cancel that. See what we get now. A lot of stuff can be ignored though. I don't see anything useful yet. Don't see anything useful yet. So let's test. Save as. And go to my documents, I guess. That's where it belongs. My doc. Text. I can actually do, see, now all of a sudden you can create a folder in documents. Damn. Sneak take out that. Christ. Actually, that doesn't make sense. Oh yeah, that does make, yeah, no, that doesn't make sense. This is also, should also apply to dir. Because, well, that file dialog, well, actually not. No. No. Because I never saw it that you are able to create a directory in your, directly in your home directory, but only in subdirectories like documents. Weird. Everything just seems to work right up to out of the box, ain't that something? Ain't that something? So weird, just not showing anything, any anything at all. It's just clean, totally clean. So that would be a quickie. Actually, this is my documents, but even in my login user I can just create a folder, I could just create a folder if I'd like to. So I was wrong. And that's not allowed. Well, it is allowed, but it's not allowed to create a this is not working. Huh? No, it's not working. Shouldn't be working. See? It can't create a div with that type. But that actually, we need to make that work. So first to events. and then also for, yeah, actually all these apps that do it, but I'm can't basically imagine now which apps might need it. So you have the type position that needs to be file in dir, so you actually need to be able to create a dir in there. With a generic content type, obviously. So let's try that again. Now we have it. Yeah. No deepest chatting. There was something I would like to. Oh yeah, right. So let's just so now I created this file, my doc. Now does it actually find it if I do my? Yep, it does. And now if I open this, it does open it. Let's see if we ever see anything else with regard to that. Yeah, that Nautilus search provider. So that search provider is actually trying to execute it. This can be audited. These are don't audited, but that execute is weird. It doesn't actually need to execute it because let's see if it actually needs to execute it. My, yeah, it actually needs to execute it. So, search provider needs to actually run all these apps as well, not the search provider. Getting messy, but at least now I know. So this is going to be messy, a lot of work, but yeah, it had to be done. So first of all, let's go to Froller. If you see a, if you're looking for a first do this one. Yeah. If you're searching for a tar gzip, and you want to basically actually run that right from that menu, then you'll need Nautilus Search Provider to actually transition to file loader. So yeah, there's a lot of room for optimization here, indeed. the same goes for events. But that's basically not so spread out. Runs events. And then what else? See if this still builds. Yeah. Then de-edit. Search. They all run gedit. Kinda messy this way, but it happens. So yeah, by testing it, by trying it out, you'll learn a lot of stuff and you'll need to change a lot of stuff. Loose ends, I'll categorize that as. But this app is going pretty smooth so far. So yeah, my, and now it should run. Not quite. Probably Divas chat. Yeah, looks like it. Weird. So, what else could cause this? What else could cause this? My dog death. Actually have two. Oh yeah, that's right. Why isn't it opening? Might be related to this stuff here. Let's try this in permissive mode. see what. Let me see. Nothing significant. So it probably has to do with this stuff here. Oh right, there's some Beatles chatting going on. Jared wants to chat itself. Maybe that's it. That would be more feasible. This soon and see if that changes anything. It's pretty weird how some of these apps just use Beatles to chat to themselves. I'm like, why can't you use a FIFO file or something like that? But that probably goes for these other apps as well. They probably want to chat to themselves. Xenoforce 1. Search my. Doing it. Related to this stuff here. It's about the only thing I can come up with. So weird. Let's just try it out. So here we don't audited some stuff with regard to opening files. Where is it? Here, this stuff here. So let's just test that. And allow that. See if that's related. Must be something. There's always a rational explanation. It works. So we're going to do this. So this is basically this sucks. What we're gonna do is don't edit this. Allow this and allow this. It's a little bit stupid though. Let's see if this works. Basically, we're allowing it to read, write generic use home content. We're not allowing it to read, write any other home user home content, and we're not allowing it to write to the user home dir. And now it's no longer working. And the other one, this one is working. What does that tell us? Although it has issues, see, this tells me the following. This might be actually it. And actually, that's not even the full story either. This needs to be there and a file. Actually, now I'm getting all screwed up. Let's comment this out. Now it's getting all screwed up. Testing. No, it just doesn't do that. It's so weird because I thought I knew how this stuff works, but seems I don't. And maybe it's just not a testing, it's just basically actually inheriting something. basically the only thing I can come up with. But this should work. Works, although it does seem to be trying to do something, but anyways, that's for now, that's fine. What we're going to do now is this module B, actually first open a file again. Let's see, module B. Module B, and then just try this all over a couple times again. In enforce mode and with the don't audit gone. So look out. We're at the X5 lock, so next time it's going to hang. At X6 it's usually hanging, so that next time we're logging out, we're gonna have been some issues. So let's just act as if we just don't know anything, get a force, and see if it works. So I'm just going to do what people do, I guess. Let's see. Documents. New folder. Test. And inside that folder, I'm doing name. Can't actually create a file yet. So weird. I don't know how to get this option where you basically can create a file. It's probably in this dir in templates that somehow, yeah, see in this dir there's some different behavior. Test. Here you have a new document. Empty document. And open that, edit, and add some stuff in there and say, just say that. File link. Use empty. Oh, yeah. Loose ends. Let's try this again. That's it. Save this somewhere else. Home directory. Open. You can show hidden files. That's weird. It shouldn't. Oh yeah, it can actually search all these dirs. Which I don't want. If possible, I'd like to not allow that. See if that breaks anything. It's gonna break stuff, probably. Oh, and I need to build before I install, obviously. I prefer not to delete all theirs if possible. Now we have other stuff that, but it does seem to kind of work. It wants to open and jump the home to, and that's obvious. Problem is now also that you can actually see, so I need to manually get it and jump open. Yeah, it just makes sense. There's other stuff as well. For example, you see, if it reads it, it opens it. For this here. For generic user content, search read open. Yeah, that's fine. A lot of loose ends though. What's the best history doing now? And that old route, a little bit nice. Something went a little bit nuts there. Yeah, I'm not going to do RF. Yes. Look, want some confirmation. What's that alt root? Significant, but that's basically why all these apps want to basically list that old root stuff. I'm not sure why that, why it is the way it is. All right, now that's basically it. It looks okay. It looks okay. the test file. Test one. Now it works. Odd behavior. Now it doesn't work. Odd behavior. Let's see, module. Maybe some deepest chatting that I'm overlooking again. Chip provider, actually not just not chip provider, a whole bunch of stuff. Tail and kind of audit too. So keep going, chip provider. Tracker store. So yeah, there's a lot of loose ends. Lot to learn, a lot of investigation to do, a lot of testing. Oh, ships. Ran the wrong command. It happens. People make mistakes. Especially people like me. As long as I don't make the same mistake twice or thrice, that's not proper English. Okay, let's try that again. Now it might work because there's some chatting going on. Yeah, now it works, at least. There's still some thinking going on. Not sure why that is. Nothing out of the ordinary. So let's just chalk that up to that Divas chats. Yeah, but at least now we have a text editor. It's always a good idea to have a text editor. I'll save this. Please select the folder below. I'm just going to create a folder. Joe. And inside that folder I'm going to save it. Oh, nah, where is it? Joe, what's it called? Yeah, and save document. So then why isn't it? Joe text. And of course this probably won't work either. Yeah. Doesn't run. So Nautilus also so many. Not switch provider. Rinse and out this. I don't understand why. I can't find my Joe text. I do not understand that. Open a shell. LSLZ. Now we have the Joe. It's proper directory. LS Joe. That's a Joe text file. LS Joe. don't know. Let's just try that again. Weird. Don't see anything significant, but it just doesn't. Oh right, that is probably related. It's all old. So do that once more. Blah blah blah. Save as. Create a folder. Blah blah. Text, create a folder, blah, and let's save that in there. Now let's have a look. What do we have here? We have nothing. Nothing significant. So it's just... Are you telling me that... Are you telling me that it just not finds anything? No. It finds this dir, but that file inside there, it just doesn't find that. Now that's some weird behavior right there. Now, I'm not sure if that's just because of me. One thing's for sure, there's a lot of loose ends. You kidding me? Oh right, that's not allowed. Oh, this is not a generic file, so that's just not allowed. No. You can't open that. You're not allowed to. You'll probably see an ABC now for that. These are all legit. GPFS, the recent. Yeah, this needs to be reviewed. It needs to edit the GTK bookmark stuff, probably. GVFSD recent. Bookmark support. But that's so weird how all how many of these programs actually check for or actually read to. Now that's not a problem though, but it's just weird. So this is one thing. This is so weird. let's just keep this at least this way. See, it can't open it these files, so I don't really have to worry about it actually reading it, because you can't read file or without opening it. But for some stupid reason, it just, and usually I think, well, that's a test, but it's not a test either. At least either that, or I'm using that but as long as it's generic content, I'm not so worried about it, because, well, generic content isn't supposed to be protected anyways. I'm going to log out again, but not delete the DIRS. Just basically log out and log in, see if that exposes more issues all over the place. And now, of course, TDM is going to crap out on me. Yep. It's about the sixth or seventh time, and then TDM just creeps out. And he says, I have enough. I've had enough. Well, I should just at least kill all you, my login user. That's one thing I should do. Get a force. Let's see if I can log in. So yeah, it's getting more and more about fixing bugs. Making things just work, I guess. And again, it's not freaking starting it up. so annoying. So terribly annoying. It's so terribly annoying. Now it does. Freaking behavior. But it's, yeah, it's just having big problems. Connect the server. This is gonna crap out. Oh, actually, that's, there wasn't the edit there. See, now it's not working again. And who knows what's causing this? Now it works. Weird. Basically, all it is we get that to cache. Probably need to allow the search cache though. No, my login user get it. Let's just allow it to search cache if it's not allowed to do that already. So all these pieces of shit need to search cache. Maybe this will make a difference. Just doesn't. It makes just the more harder because it can crap out for a million and one reasons. So maybe that audit access that I did before was just fine in the first place. But yeah, since something else crept out, it still failed. So it takes just a lot of investigation, a lot of it. It's still not working. Just app is probably just so anal about it. just want to get the pulse. So I'm just going to try this. Yeah, I need to just figure this out. Because it's just eating my brain. First of all, I'm going to take care of that cache stuff. So it actually reads it and opens it, I guess. Read, open. And then we have the pulse audio stuff, and I already allowed some of this. So I'll just allow it to allow my login user Jedit T pulse audio. Home T there get attribute search open and read. Let's get this over with. Fuck. Piece of shit. Annoying. Some of these issues are just annoying. This spends a hell of a lot of time on figuring stuff out. In the meanwhile, you add stuff just to rule out stuff out, and all you have to keep track of all that stuff that you added, because you might need to undo it later. Hell. And now it seems to be more responsive. That's let's just confirm that. I can't confirm it. How crazy is that? How crazy is that? Let's try this. Now, this might actually be a good example, if this is actually it. I'm just going to add this in here. I require class see this might actually be related to this. I'm not saying it is, but it just might. At this point I'm just not ruling anything out. Getting harder and harder. More complex every time. It's still trying to do something. Just not related to. It's just not it. just not it. So I haven't actually been able to figure it out. At least not so far. I just have not been able to figure it out. This also doesn't just doesn't seem to just doesn't seem to be it. Now it opens up. Weird behavior altogether. One more time. So what turns out to be simple just exposes some irrational behavior. Log out. Kill all you my login user. Because there's this process hanging there. Spice. And actually pulls audio as well. So Some of these processes are just hanging there. Let's just try and log in without killing the process. See if that. Poses any problems. Not really. Although I have two VDA agents probably now. Yeah, I have two VDA agents, but I only have one pulse audio, so the pulse audio behaves properly, it seems. Oh, and also I've been just doing this wrong altogether. Irrational behavior. Now it opens. Find that a little bit odd. See, that search doesn't work either. Seems to not actually search something in subdirectories. Even sure if that's the idea. Let's Yeah, I can't. I'm not going to try that on the host either. So this works. This doesn't. Well, it actually does. But didn't the first time, but now it does. Can't find anything in subdirectories for some reason. Oh, we have some ABC denials. File roller sends messages to itself. And all these apps do that. That basically if you open a file from the search provider, so yeah, irrational behavior with regard to searching stuff in your home directory. Can't even find this file. So that just sucks. Actually, no, it actually does find a file. But it doesn't find that yeah, file. Weird. It's annoying me terribly. I'm kind of getting into a panic mode. It's just not doing what I'd like it to do. I just don't have a clue why that is. So it finds everything in the root fine, that's no problem. The problem is the stuff that's not in the root. So for example, if I here new document, empty document, text, I open that document and de-edit, save that. Now if I go find it can't find it. Actually now it does. But let's try that another way. So but if I open gedit and I create this file, and save as, create a new folder. Well, actually, let's just save that somewhere existence and then text save. Look for it. And it actually finds it now. Some weird, irrational behavior there. But nothing significant. And now if I go and go home and I search it finds it. Now you tell me how weird is that? Maybe it's because I added that stupid file, this blur file. Let's just do this again. Get it. Save it. Create a file. Maybe it's just because of the new dir. Oops. text and then new folder. Okay, okay, okay. And then save that. But this doesn't work. See? So it's just monitoring. Because if I do the same, and I save this to, for example, a different directory, save as, to desktop. Then it works. So this mother is very limited. It's not actually an SE Linux bug, seems. It's just searching known dirs and everything that's not known, it just doesn't search it. So yeah, I guess that's an explanation. It's just the way it works, I guess. Okay, so I guess that's an explanation. And then with regard to this, this is not it, but we need to, yeah, this is also not it, this is also not it, also not it. This, yeah, this is good. That's actually right, wasn't it? Checks seems to not work. Yeah, it does actually work. Here it is. This was it, what I was looking for. Alright, so I'll leave it at this for now. There are some glitches, but that's just basically related to GNOME itself, not so much as Linux. Since I'm just pretty thoroughly testing this stuff, I just exposed that, I guess. I have two VDA agents. Somehow it's not, VDA agent isn't killed when you log out. Not sure why that is, whether that's this is pretty yeah, it looks nasty. But at least it's some protection. At least it's hiding something. it hides the information of the kernel. Not sure. It actually shows the ID. It seems to hide the memory usage and the CPU percentage. Either that or it's just not using anything. Look at that SE troubleshoot going all the way nuts. -24%. And all the stuff that you shouldn't be able to access, you can't access, of course. So it's, yeah, we're getting somewhere, and it's getting every day there's something more. But there's still a lot of stuff that isn't done. And we should probably do the instant messenger soon. Our transmission works, at least for a bit. At least a bit. Now the backup program works, we check that out. Firefox doesn't work. Passwords and keys works. Evolution doesn't work. Events works. Gedit works now. Ifiles works. Image viewer works. And then the shell works. The system monitor works. So yeah, slowly but surely, I'm basically going to log off now. Log out, yeah. I'm basically going to update the system and reboot it. Synforce 0, just make sure I'm update. And also the host, I need to also take care of the host. It's again a new kernel. So I'm going to update the host as well, and then start from there. But yeah, this is at least the gedit part. It turned out in the beginning, I thought, well, this is going fast and smooth, and it actually did, because it's a very simple app, basically. But yeah, due to its integration with all these other apps, like for example Nautilus and stuff like that. Somehow I got somehow I strayed from the path. And but we did figure out some things, that the search provider needs to actually execute files that it finds in the programs, in the respective programs. So yeah, we did actually find out some stuff. That's something. should probably clear this at least. These were created by when I ran the keys. Program. So now we at least we're clean. I can just basically shut down. Halt. Now. It works. Oh yeah, job. So it's shut down. I'm going to close this video. I'm going to update the host as well and reboot the host because there's some kernels and I'd like to stay up to date with some of the security stuff, needless to say. So gedit was done in this exercise.